Good morning, student. Welcome back here in your social science class. Today we will discuss chapter number 4 from geography here. Okay, which chapter today we will discuss? Today we will discuss chapter number 4 here from your geography. Must know about the broad topic of this chapter. So we will divide into two broad topics for easier understanding. Fine. The first one is atmosphere. Okay, so under atmosphere we will study about what is it, then composition of the atmosphere, then structure of the atmosphere. Okay, then the next one, weather and climate. So under weather and climate, what are they? Then temperature, then air pressure, wind and moisture. We will study under these topics. So student, as you all of you know that about the air, okay, atmosphere, we have already discussed it in our previous chapter also, chapter 1. Okay, so regarding atmosphere, so the atmosphere is the thin layer of air, as you can see here in this moving diagram also here. So the atmosphere is a thin layer of air that surrounds the earth, and the gravitational force here, as you can see, the gravitational force of the earth holds the atmosphere around it. So student, our earth is surrounded by a huge blanket of air. In short, we can say that, what do you understand by atmosphere? If we talk about the our earth, so our earth is surrounded by a huge blanket of air called atmosphere. All living beings on this earth depend on the atmosphere. Where it depends? Yes, it depends on the atmosphere for their survival. It provides the air we breathe, and it also you can say that it also protects us from the harmful rains also, effects also. Yes, it also provides us the air we breathe, and it protects us from the harmful effect of the sun rays. Without this blanket of protection, we would be baked alive by the heat of the sun. आपको पता है ना कि sun की आपकी heat बहुत ज़्यादा होती है. बेटा अगर ये हमारा ये atmosphere का जो blanket है, ये नहीं होगा, तो हम बिल्कुल baked हो जाएंगे. Okay, alive by the heat of the sun during day and get frozen during night. So it is this mass of air that has made the temperature on the earth livable. Student, one important thing you also must know about the greenhouse effect. Okay, here as you can see, so carbon dioxide released in the atmosphere and creates a greenhouse effect by trapping the heat radiant from the earth. ओके, जस्ट लाइक आपका जो ग्रीन हाउस इफेक्ट कैसे होता है, जो आपके कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड रिलीज होती है आपके एटमॉस्फेयर में, वो आपके ग्रीन हाउस इफेक्ट करती है क्या करके, जो आपके हीट और रेडिएशन होता है अर्थ का. इट इज़ देयरफॉर इट इज़ कॉल्ड अ ग्रीन गैस. ओके, ग्रीन हाउस गैस. एंड विदाउट इट द अर्थ वुड हैव बीन टू कोल्ड टू लिव इन. अगर ये नहीं होगा तो आपका जो अर्थ है वो बहुत ज़्यादा क्या हो जाएगा, बहुत ज़्यादा कोल्ड हो जाएगा. Okay, however, when its level in the atmosphere increased due to the factory smoke or car fume, the heat retained increased the temperature of the earth, and this is called the global warming. So now student, all of you know about the greenhouse gases. Okay, so greenhouse gases, without it the earth would have been too cold to live in. Agar ye nahi hongi to bahut hi thanda ho jayega rehne ke liye. But ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, व्हेन द लेवल इन द एटमॉस्फेयर इंक्रीजेस, जो आपका इंक्रीज हो रहा है लेवल ऑफ द एटमॉस्फेयर, जैसे आपका हो गया ड्यू टू फैक्ट्री स्मोक, कार फ्यूम हो गया, हीट हो गया, सो रिटेन इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द अर्थ एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. दिस राइज इन टेम्परेचर कॉज द स्नो इन द कोल्डेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड टू मेल्ट. As you can see, you know what, one important thing beta also, as a result the sea level rises. क्या हो रहा है आपका, जब melt हो रहा है आपका snow part, आपका temperature increase हो रहा है due to global warming. Okay, आपका earth का temperature increase हो रहा है, so due to this rise in the temperature causes the snow in the coldest part. आपके जो glacier है melt हो रहे हैं, coldest part melt हो रहे हैं, so as a result the sea levels rises. What result? Yes, sea level rises, causing floods in the coastal areas. There may be drastic change in the climate of a place, leading to extinction of some plants and animals in the long run. As you all, if you know that now the climate is changing. Climate आपका change हो रहा है, आपका summer है, आपका winter है, okay? ये सारे climate आपके temperature also going rise up. Temperature आपका बहुत ज़्यादा जा रहा है. Even if you talk about the R city Dehradun also, that time if you talk about the before 20 to 25 years, वहाँ हमारे temperature नहीं जाता था बेटा इतना, मे बी 30, 28, 30, 32, बट नाउ टुडे एट प्रेजेंट आपको पता है कि आपका समर्स में 38 एंड 40 तक राइज हो जाता है. सो ऑल दीज बिकॉज ऑफ द ग्लोबल वार्मिंग एंड इट इज अ ड्रास्टिक चेंज इन द क्लाइमेट ऑफ अ प्लेस, इवन नॉट इन आर हियर, all around the earth also, okay? And it is the extinction of some plants and animals also in the long run. Now students, just look at here, okay? Composition of the air or gases present in the atmosphere. Here as you can see in this picture, you know, do you know that the air we take in while breathing is actually a mixture of many gases? Yes, it is a mixture of many gases. Nitrogen and oxygen. Which one? Yes, nitrogen and oxygen. So nitrogen and oxygen are two gases which make up the bulk of the atmosphere. These two gases make up the bulk of the atmosphere. Okay, carbon dioxide, then helium, then ozone, then argon and hydrogen are found in lesser quantities also. Okay. Apart from these gases, tiny dust particles also are present in the air. So as you can see here, this chart will tell you about the percentage. First we will talk about the nitrogen. Okay, it is 78%. Okay, then we talk about the oxygen, it is 21%. Okay, and then if we talk about the carbon dioxide, okay, it is 0.03%. Okay, then what about the argon? Yes, if we talk about the argon, it is 0.93%. Okay, then what about the all others? One thing also now left, all others. What about the all other? If you talk about the all others, 0.04%. Now got it? Again listen beta, nitrogen 78%, then oxygen 21%, and then carbon dioxide 0.03%, then argon 0.93%, then all others 0.04%. So the pie chart gives the percentage of the different constituents of air. You know, nitrogen, if you talk about the nitrogen is the most plentiful gas in the air. When we inhale, we take some amount of nitrogen into our lungs and exhale it. हम उसको एक्सहेल करते हैं, ओके, जब हम इनहेल करते हैं लंग्स में. बट प्लांट्स ऑल्सो नीड नाइट्रोजन फॉर देयर सर्वाइवल, ओके, विच यू थिंक? यस, प्लांट ऑल्सो नीड नाइट्रोजन फॉर देयर सर्वाइवल. दे कैन नॉट टेक नाइट्रोजन डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम द एयर, वो डायरेक्टली नहीं लेते, ओके. सो nitrogen directly from the air. Bacteria that live in the soil and roots of the some plant take nitrogen from the air and change into form so that plant can use it. So now you got it about the plants also. Plants need nitrogen for their survival. So they cannot take nitrogen directly from the air. वो directly nitrogen नहीं लेते air से. Bacteria that live in the soil and roots. Which bacteria? Yes, here. The bacteria that live in the soil and roots of some plants take nitrogen from the air and change its form so that plant can use it. Then we will talk about the oxygen. Okay. So oxygen is the second most plentiful gas in the air. Humans, animals, आपको पता है, as well if you know that humans, animals take oxygen from the air as they breathe. But if we talk about the green plants, okay, which plant? Yes, हम हैं और plants and animals, human beings तो directly लेते हैं. But what about the green plants? If we talk about the green plant produce oxygen during photosynthesis. You have already studied about the photosynthesis process also in your science and even your previous class also, beta. Okay. So what thing? Photosynthesis. Okay. So oxygen is the second most plentiful gas in the air, and humans and animals take oxygen from the air as they breathe. But green plant produce oxygen when? Yes, they produce oxygen from the air as they breathe. Green plant produce oxygen during photosynthesis. In this way, oxygen content in the air remains constant. If we cut the trees, as well, if we know that ki save the trees, otherwise from where we will get the oxygen? आपको पता है कि inhale करते हैं हम लोग oxygen, okay? From where? Trees. Trees से ही तो हमें मिलता है. So that's why if we cut the trees, then this balance get disturbed. Then we will talk about the carbon dioxide also, student. So carbon dioxide is another important gas. Okay, it is also another important gas. So green plant use carbon dioxide to make their food. Okay, so which one? Yes, green plants. Okay, green plants use carbon dioxide to make their food and release oxygen. अपना food बनाते हैं वो carbon dioxide से. Here as you can see. Okay, and then the amount of carbon dioxide released by humans or animals seems to be equal to the amount then used by plants, which make a perfect balance. It is necessary better to a perfect balance according to the carbon dioxide and which one? Oxygen. A perfect balance is very much necessary. However, the balance is upset by burning of fuels such as coal and oil also. Some of the fuels also burning such as coal and oil. So they add billions of tons of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere each year. Billions of tons. Just let think about ki fuel and aapke jo coal and oil burn se hote hain aapke, billions of tons carbon dioxide aapke atmosphere mein aa jati hai. So as a result, the increased volume of carbon dioxide is affecting the earth's weather and climate. Now student, just look at here. Fine, our next topic is structure of the atmosphere. So if you talk about the structure of the atmosphere, so our atmosphere is divided into five layers. How many layers? Yes, it is divided into five layers. Okay, and these layers starting from the earth surface. Okay, here as you can see the here. So a structure of the earth can be divided into five layers, and these layers starting from the earth surface. Okay, now let's talk about the first one, troposphere. Okay, which is the first one? Troposphere. Then the second one is stratosphere. Okay, then the third one is mesosphere. Then the fourth one is thermosphere, and the last one is exosphere. Now student, we will study about the more deeply about these layers, okay, of atmosphere. So first we will talk about the troposphere. So this layer is the most important layer of the atmosphere. So here the question comes, which is the most important layer of the atmosphere? It is troposphere. Its average height is 13 kilometer. How much average height? 13 kilometer. Okay, and the air we breathe exists here. As well, if we know that air, oxygen, we breathe. So where we found it? We found it in troposphere. Okay, almost all the weather phenomena also, just like rainfall, fog, and hailstorm occur in this layer. Got it? Now the student, just look at the second one. The second one is stratosphere. Okay, so just above the troposphere lies the stratosphere. जो आपके troposphere है, so just above the troposphere, which layer we found? We found stratosphere. Okay, it extends up to a height of 50 kilometer. Up to a which height? Here as you can see, up to a height of 50 kilometer. Okay, this layer is almost free from clouds. Yes, this layer is almost free from clouds and associated with weather phenomena, making conditions and most ideal for flying aeroplanes. So here the question, which is the layer which is most ideal or most appropriate for the flying aeroplane? Which layer is it? It is stratosphere. One important feature of the stratosphere is that it contains a layer of ozone gas. This one is very important. It contains a layer of ozone gas. Okay, and we have just learned how it protects us from the harmful effect of the sun rays. Now the student, just look at here. The next one is mesosphere. Okay, mesosphere. So this is the third. So here the question comes, which is the third layer? Mesosphere. Okay, so mesosphere, this is the third layer of the atmosphere, and it lies above the stratosphere. Okay, it extends up to 80 kilometer. How much kilometer? 80 kilometer. And meteoroids also. One
up in the sphere on entering from the space. If we talk about the meteoroids, which we came from the where? From the space. So meteoroids burn up in the which layer? Mesosphere. Now the next one is thermosphere. Okay, fine student, which is the next one? Thermosphere. So in thermosphere, temperature rises very rapidly with increasing height. According to the height, you can say that temperature also rising. Okay, then ionosphere is a part of this layer. One important layer also, ionosphere. You must know about the ionosphere. So ionosphere is a part of this layer. It extends between 800 to 400 kilometer. How much? Yes, it extends between 80 to 400 kilometer. This layer helps in radio transmission. Which we think this layer आपकी क्या help करती है radio transmission में? कौन सी आपकी जो layer है? Which one? Yes, thermosphere. Okay. In fact, radio waves transmitted from the earth and reflect back to the earth by this layer. जो आपके transmitted होते हैं वो earth से reflect होते हैं. Then the last one is exosphere. So exosphere, the uppermost layer of the atmosphere is exosphere. So here the different, uppermost is exosphere. And if we talk about the first and important layer, it is troposphere. Got it? So the uppermost layer of the atmosphere is known as exosphere. And this layer has very thin air. Okay, this one, okay, this layer has very thin air and light gases like helium and hydrogen float into the space from here. Now student, let's talk about the weather and climate. Just look at the outside student, is it going to rain today? Yes or no? Or will it be bright and sunny today? How many of times you have heard this from NXS cricket fans also speculating the fate of one day match. If we imagine our body to be radio and the mind its speaker, weather is something that fiddles with its control knobs. How? So there is a difference between the meaning of the weather and climate. Now let's talk about the weather and climate. Talk about the weather. So many times you have watched in news also today's weather, today's forecast also, what about the temperature and all these things, is it sunny day or is it rain today, so many things. So we will talk about the weather and climate. What's the difference between weather and climate? First of all, what is weather? So weather is the R2R day-to-day condition of the atmosphere. Listen very carefully, it is the condition between which we think आर टू आर एंड डे टू डे. इट मीन्स अभी आपका वेदर कुछ है बिफोर आर वन एंड टू आर इट मे बी समथिंग चेंज हो जाए. सो वेदर इज द बिच थिंग आर टू आर एंड डे टू डे कंडीशन ऑफ द एटमोसफियर. अ हॉट और ह्यूमिड वेदर मे मेक वन इरिटेबल. ऑल इफ यू नो अबाउट जब बहुत ज़्यादा गर्मी होती है, सो इट कैन बी हॉट और ह्यूमिड और pleasant and breezy and so on. Now tell me student, what about the today's weather? So you have to write, this is your activity also, you have to do activity in your social science notebook, in your geography notebook, you have to write about today's weather. Is it sunny? Is it rain today? What else? And about the temperature, it is humid, it is pleasant and breezy, what about? So weather can change dramatically from day to day. Now we got it, the answer. Weather is the R2R day to day condition of the atmosphere and it can be changed dramatically from day to day. Got it? Now we will talk about the climate. What is climate? So the average weather condition of a place. Here is the difference between, now we are talking about the climate. So the average weather condition of a place for a long period of time. Wet it means जब आपका long period of time, represently the climate of a place. Got it? So weather can change dramatically, you know that. And if you talk about the which thing, climate, so it is a longer period of time which represent the climate of a place. Now do you understand why we have daily weather forecast? Because it changing day to day and hour to hour. Okay, now here the one under the temperature. So the temperature you feel every day. Now what about the temperature? Same thing you have to write down. I have given one activity also. So same thing, if you talk about the temperature, so the temperature you feel every day is the temperature of the atmosphere jo hum day to day feel karte hain. Okay, now we will talk about the, what do you understand by temperature. So the degree of hotness and coldness. Which thing? Yes, जो degree होती है आपकी, the degree of hotness. How much hot today and how much cold today according to winter season, according to the rainy season and according to the summer season. There is a difference between, okay, climate. So the degree of hotness and coldness of the air is known as the temperature. Got it? The temperature of the atmosphere changes between, okay, it may be changes between which is thing about day and night, okay, not only between day and night but also from season to season. Aisa nahi hai ki day and night mein aapka temperature change hoga, but you all of you know about the summer season are hotter, and if you talk about the winter colder, and if you talk about the now as it is rainy season is going humid temperature. So and which thing? Yes, the temperature of the atmosphere changes not only between day and night but also from season to season. Summer are hotter than winters. One important thing also, if now we will talk about the insulation. So what do you understand by insulation? An important factor that influences the distribution of the temperature. Wo factor, which factor? Important factor which influence which thing? Distribution of the temperature. Jo aapka distribution of the temperature ko influence karta hai, it is known as insulation. And insulation is the incoming solar energy intercepted by the earth. Which energy? Yes, solar energy and intercepted by the earth. The amount of insulation also decreases. If we talk about the amount of insulation according to the area, so the amount of insulation decreases from the equator towards the pole. Now look at here, student. Okay, now you got it, the meaning of the insulation. What do you understand by insulation? An important which thing? Yes, insulation means an important factor that influences the distribution of the temperature. Here as you can see, okay, so it is a distribution of the temperature, influence the distribution of the temperature is insulation. And insulation is the incoming solar energy interrupted by the earth. The amount of insulation decreases from the equator towards the poles, therefore the temperature, okay, that's why if you talk about the which thing, temperature. So therefore which thing, temperature decrease, okay, temperature kahan decrease karta hai, in the same manner, okay. So temperature decrease, it gets colder as we go from the equator towards the pole. Agar hum equator towards the pole, okay, to wahan aapka temperature kya hai, decrease karta hai, and the poles are covered with snow. All of you know about the poles, poles are covered with snow. So temperature decreases and which thing, it gets colder, thanda ho jata hai beta agar hum jate hain equator se पोल की तरफ. एंड इफ द टेम्परेचर राइजेस टू मच, आई नाउ एट जस्ट अपोजिट टू द, ओके, इज द टेम्परेचर राइजेस टू मच, इट वुड बिकम टू वार्म फ्रॉम सम क्रॉप्स टू ग्रो. ओके, नाउ वन इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन स्टूडेंट, टेल मी, ओके, जस्ट लेट्स थिंक एंड टेल मी, टेम्परेचर इन सिटीज इज मच हायर देन दैट ऑफ विलेज. विच वन टेम्परेचर इज मच हायर, इज इट सिटीज और इज इट विलेज? टेल मी, there is a question. Temperature in cities is much higher than the that of village. Why? What's the reason? Kiska temperature hota hai zyada in cities or in village? Yes, the answer is temperature in village. So why, what's the reason, temperature in village? Now if we talk about the which thing, metals in buildings and the एस्पेलेट ऑफ रोड्स गेट हीटेड अप ड्यूरिंग द डे. जो ये सारी चीज़ें होती हैं आपकी, सन के हीट से एकदम आपकी क्या होती है, हीटअप हो जाती हैं. सो द हीट इज रिलीज ड्यूरिंग द नाइट, और वो हीट कब आपके रिलीज होती है, नाइट में, ओके. एंड ऑल्सो द क्राउडेड हाई राइज बिल्डिंग, एज यू ऑल ऑफ यू नो अबाउट, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द सिटीज, द क्राउडेड हाई राइज बिल्डिंग्स ऑफ द सिटीज टैप द वार्म एयर, ओके, एंड दस रेज द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द सिटीज. So student, after this, just look at the important things also. We will talk about the weather instruments. So just look at here, the first one is thermometer. It measures the temperature. Got it? Now just look at the second one, it is barometer. Got it? Yes, barometer, and it measures the atmospheric pressure. And which is the third one? Rain gauge. Okay, and rain gauge, it measures the amount of rainfall.
and which is the next one, wind vane. It shows the direction of the wind. So these are the four instrument, weather instrument, which is the first one, thermometer, then barometer, then rain gauge, then wind vane. Okay, one important thing also, you will be very surprised to know that, okay, if you talk about the fish thing, yes, only come to know, you will be very surprised to know that earth receives only one part, okay, about 200 crore, how much, 200 crore part of the sun's energy. सोचिए कितना हॉट है आपका सन, और सिर्फ इतनी नहीं, हमें कितना ज़्यादा टेम्परेचर हमारा बहुत ज़्यादा हाई जाता है. ओके, एंड द स्टैंडर्ड यूनिट ऑफ मेजरिंग टेम्परेचर इज डिग्री सेल्सियस. बट यस, डिग्री सेल्सियस, एंड इट वॉज इन्वेंटेड बाय एंड्रेस सेल्सियस. ओके, होम इन्वेंटेड, इन्वेंटेड बाय एंड्रेस सेल्सियस. ऑन द सेल्सियस स्केल द वाटर फ्रीज एट 0 degree Celsius. Water freezes at how much? 0 degree Celsius, and boils at 100 degree Celsius. These are the important thing. So this is the first part of this video. Second part, you have to watch to solve the worksheet. Okay, you have to must watch the both two parts.